Welcome to another Teardown video. This time it is another Linak table power supply controllers. This time it is a much older model, see? So this is 20 years old. It looks a lot different. Motor connectors, they are a lot different. And here is the table buttons. Again, they use the same power supply connector without earth. I must say it is a little bit against my religion not to have earth on stuff like this. I would really prefer if all metal parts on this table was connected together to earth, just for safety. All right, so let's open this thing and have a look. Torx 20, that is easy. So that was all the screws. This is exactly what I expected. Super easy to pull apart. Wow, look at that. This is a lot different. So, a lot of stuff happened. Of course, you would also expect a lot of progress. Wow, look at that, relays. What is that? Power supply, regulators, rectifiers, two and two in parallel, or something like that. I have to look a little bit more into this before I come with any clever comments. So that is the microcontroller. It's a beautiful layout. Oh, look at that. Okay, so they're crossing over here. Really good quality PCB as well. I wonder what was the idea about putting the rectifiers down like that. So, is it because of height? Because this is placed on top of the transformator, so this is really a height thing. How wonderful isn't it just? Still, they love these really, really big capacitors. Yeah. And the fuse on a separate board. Okay, this is because this cable can't just go straight out. When you need a fuse somewhere. So, okay. We need a PCB and a fuse socket and all those connectors. That's just the way it is. Looks like they prepared for it here. Yeah, look at that. See, some connectors and a fuse here. And again, those connectors. So the transformator could have been connected here with an SMD type socket. And the fuse could have been here to save the cost of all this assembly. Whoa, look at that. Oy. There is actually a thread. Oy. Let's see, how can you... Oh, I need... How is this done? Whew. Phew, I just had the fight of my life to get this thing undone. Are you kidding me? That was tough. What a fight! Of course there was not a threat. No way. This is pressed in, and those are like grippers that grip and lock. And the only way to get this undone, you need some sort of a tool that goes around here, that just go down, so you can pull it up. But what I did is, I took a big flat screwdriver, and let's try and put this on. See? And then I just press the screwdriver right in here. Quick. You know, and then break down all the plastic holding things. And this way, I was able to damage this so much, so it's possible now to pull it up. And I think that I was able to do this without causing damage to the golden piece. This is, of course, what I want to keep for all sorts of funny projects. This is really nice, a good size. I removed the big capacitor and the AC input, just so we can easier see what's going on. See the two AC lines. This is a little bit of a reroute or detour, but all those are of course one AC, and look, the other AC is here, and then it goes here, and then it goes to all the other diodes, and then again the positive and the negatives, and the positive goes straight to the capacitor. This is the big one, so there's also a possibility to put on two big SMD capacitors if you want that. Then this positive go to all the relays, and of course the relays, that is to change the direction of the two DC motors. When you want to start and stop the DC motors, you do this with a field effect transistor, not the relay. Relays is only for changing direction. And then the motor current is of course monitored by sense resistors and op amp, so that the processor will know if a motor is stalled or not. So then there is an LM317 normal positive regulator, but this field effect transistor is for something really, really smart. This is of course for idle current. So see, this is all the negative diodes. This pad here is connected to this pad. Or I think it was, oh damn it, come on. Yeah, here it is. So this is the negative, and it goes here and here. So this little thing goes to the rest of the logic and an idle supply. And then, see? Those two, so you can have two in parallel, but they are doing perfectly fine with only one. So what happens is, when you push the button here, the system will wake up and enable this FET, and it will power on the whole system so that you will get full power. So this thing can actually idle and draw almost nothing in standby. So that is fantastic. And by the way, when it comes to idle and power standby, those transformators, they run really, really cold. There's almost nothing wasted in idle mode, so they're specially designed for low idle power. And this is one of the reasons I love to use them. And look, it's looking like it was new. But this one is 20 years old.